How do you design a space which is calm, elegant, functional, and simple? There's one interior design style that helps you achieve all of this. It's called Japandi. And trust me, I think this is going to be the go-to trend in India because it's focused on practicality, aesthetics, health, and wellness. Hi, I'm Architect Pitsa Kamboj, and welcome to my deep dive into Japandi interiors. We are going to be talking about what it is, the elements which make a design Japandi, and how can you incorporate them into your spaces. So, Japandi interiors are basically a combination of Japanese interiors, which look something like this, mixed with a Scandinavian design style. And now it's not like you can just pick any two design styles and just mix them together. The reason these two blend so seamlessly is because they balance each other out, being polar opposites with just a few common characteristics, which are natural elements, sustainability, and focus on comfort. Now, this style focuses on bringing nature inside by using organic shapes and natural materials like stone wood, bamboo, linen, etc., while keeping the entire space clean and uncluttered. Japandi Woodwork, I feel like this is such a relaxing concept. It allows your mind to truly relax with the soft and neutral color schemes of white, beige, and jet greens. Now, this also gives you the chance to add darker accents and create a beautiful focal point because of the contrast between beige. So, one thing that I really appreciate here is how every choice is very thought out carefully with the focus on quality and longevity rather than just making everything aesthetically pleasing. Now, let's get down to the application of Japandi. How do you make this functional for an Indian home which is so cluttered and occupied? The answer is furniture. Furniture makes all the difference in the world, and let me give you a room by room breakdown for it. First, let's start with the kitchen, the most cluttered space of them. Introducing stone countertops paired with wooden cabinets to hide the everyday cluttery are perfect for personality. A minimal white shelf like this one can be used to add some decor and frequently accessed items, which go with themes like cups and chopping boards. You need to have lots of extra photos for the living room. So while you're approaching the living room, it's important to focus on the elements of Japandi to maintain the cohesiveness of the design in your space. Now, since the color palette of the space will be neutral, you can incorporate colors by adding subtle accents of neutral colors like sage green, dusk in blue, using your accessories and your tech. Or you can also create interesting visual elements by using texture like this. Now, as for the furniture, clean lines are the way to go. Choose multifunctional furniture which features natural material. Alright. An interesting combination I like to see is Scandinavian style sofas like these, paired with Japanese low-inspired tables. Add small accents to this by using textured fabric, throws, cushions, and rug, but remember to keep it simple. I'll probably say this a million times in this video, but natural light is such a crucial part of Japandi interiors, and it creates a warm, soothing environment. You can add pendant light for a soft glow and floor lamps with a metal or a wooden base. Now, to add finishing touches to the space, add greenery with water plants to keep the space light and refreshing. Then, moving on to the space which should be the most calming, the bedroom. So if you really want to embrace the Japandi theme in the bedroom and put an emphasis on Japan, then use low to ground furniture, especially bed. Avoid cluttering your space with accessories. Use a few statement pieces and add natural material like wardrobe shutters which have rattan on accents of bamboo or wood. Now for lighting, use minimalistic lamps for a very soft glow and make the most of natural light in this space. And last, but definitely not the least, your bathroom. This cannot be an afterthought. And don't worry, your bathroom can be transformed into Japandi heaven in a very budget-friendly way. For your sanitary fixtures, go with black powder-coated fixtures to create a contrast in the space without adding clutter. You can also look for wooden vanities with stone countertops and use glossy ceramic tiles for the walls. Now, incorporate functional and hidden storage solutions. such as floating wooden shelves or cabinets can help you create the space which is clutter-free. Now go to your local markets and source wicker or bamboo baskets for additional storage. वैसे तो there is no need for accessories here, but if you still want to incorporate something, just make sure that they are purposeful. You can use ceramic or glass containers for toiletries, various small wooden stool or a simple plant. Do not let this get overwhelming. This is where the whole design scheme usually falls apart. Now, before we move on to how it can be incorporated in Indian context, make sure to hit the subscribe button. So, while I was doing my research on Japandi design style, I found this beautifully executed Japandi home in Bangalore by the Design Collaborative. It has everything that makes a house a home, while being perfectly Japandi: clean lines, bright spaces, and light colors to create the perfect balance of function and form. So it's drowned with natural light during the daytime because of the beautiful floor-to-ceiling windows with a warm mix of wooden flooring, pattern tile flooring, and grey tile flooring. The living room is fairly simple with neutral tone furniture and walls, but an amazing balance has been created by adding clean lines and geometric shapes on the cushions and throw blinds. The artwork also features simple shapes matching with the neutral doors and accents of metal and wood, while adding a touch of greenery with potted plants. Their kitchen actually surprised me. The mint green PU lacquered shutters are a very different take on Japandi design, but it pairs beautifully with the wooden bar stools. I loved it. The pattern flooring really helps break the monotony of the mostly solid kitchen. Now, the dining room features a beautiful wooden dining table to serve as a focal point with simple artwork and black pendant lights. Moving on to the bedroom, it has an abundance of natural light with no wooden bed and floating side tables, keeping the furniture minimal yet functional. I really like the way this home has been designed. It's a great way to implement a design as simple and minimal as Japandi in an Indian context. Now the question on everyone's mind: ye sundar to bahut hai, but is it actually practical for my home? And paise kitne lagenge? Well, to answer the first question, yes, it is practical. But just like every design style, it has to be adjusted to fit your needs. It needs to be designed in a way where it makes your life peaceful and efficient. And paisa, realistically, it would start from ₹1,000 per square feet, including furniture, decor, and basic renovations, and can go higher to even ₹3,500 per square feet based on how premium finishes you choose. I would personally give this style an 8 on 10. Would you use this in your home? Let me know your thoughts and your questions in the comments below. And don't forget to like and subscribe this video if it helped. Bye.